हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम प्रोफेसर दर्शना मोरे, के वा कॉलेज ऑफ हॉर्टिकल्चर, नासिक। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द कल्टीवेशन प्रैक्टिसेस ऑफ रबर। बोटैनिकली रबर इज कॉल्ड एज हेविया ब्रासिलेंसिस। इट इज डिप्लॉयड प्लांट एंड क्रोमोसोम नंबर इज 2N=36। इट इज पेरेनियल इन नेचर and monoecious tree, that means male and female flowers are present on the same flowers. Then it is cross pollinated and belongs to the family Euphorbiaceae. In rubber there are different species. First is Hevia brasiliensis, it is commonly known as para rubber. Then Ficus elastica, Indian rubber, Manihot glazy bovi, Sierra rubber, and Plastiola elastica, Panama rubber. These are the different species of rubber, but most commonly cultivated species is Hevia brasiliensis. Area and production of rubber. In the world scenario, Thailand is a major producing rubber producing country. Then next to the Thailand, Indonesia, Malaysia, India. India ranked fourth in rubber production. Then Vietnam, China, other. In Thailand, the production of rubber is 30.6 lakh ton, and percent in share of production is 31.4%. In Indian scenario, the Kerala and Kanyakumari are district of Tamil Nadu, most rubber producing states. The area is 64% and production is 94.14%. And also the cultivated in northeastern states, then other non-traditional states also. Then the morphology of rubber. Flowers are born in many flowered axillary shortly pubescent panicle on the basal part of the new flush. Both female and male flowers are present on the same plant. It is unisexual plant, and small flowers are present. It is scented in nature, then shortly stalk with longer bell shape. Female flowers occur at the terminal position of the flowers, and male flowers are present at lateral portions. The flower take place over a period of about 2 weeks, with some male flowers opening first, lasting for 1 day and then dropping, followed by female flowers open for 3 to 5 days, and then remainder of male flowers then open. Then fruit structure, fruit and seed. Only small proportion of female flowers set fruit, and of this 30 to 50% fall off after a month and more fall off later. Then nature of mature fruit is large compress, 3-lobe capsule, 3 to 5 cm in diameter, with 3 oil containing seeds. The capsule bursts open at the end of the rainy season with the characteristic loud bang, similar a rifle shot. The seeds are then collected for sowing in the nursery. So the next part is soil and climatic nature requirement of rubber. So the first is soil. Rubber grows well in highly well aerated soil consisting of lateritic soil. It prefers well-drained porous soil which are moderate to highly acidic in nature. The depth is required minimum 1 meter without any intervening hard pan or impenetrable layer. Then the water table should be below 1 meter to ensure the good aeration for root penetration. pH is 4.5 to 6. Then temperature, it can be grown on 10 degree north and 10 degrees south latitude. Rainfall requirement is more than 2000 mm. temperature 25 to 28 degrees Celsius and relative humidity is 80%. Its required sunshine is 2000 hours per year. At the rate, that means in a day, 6 hours. Weather condition warm and moist is suitable for rubber trees. Then weather, cold weather and high wind speed affect the production of rubber. Then the varieties of rubber. There are different varieties are present in rubber. TJ, PB6, PB86, BD5, BD10, PR17, GT1, RRII105, RRIM600, PB28, 59, PB217, PB235, RR, that is Rubber Research Institute of Malaya, 703, PCK1, 2, and PB26, 206. So these are the varieties of rubber. So the high yielding varieties is RRII105, Rubber Research Institute of India. It is high yielding variety 105. The latex yield is more from that variety. Then next part is the propagation. Seed propagation. Prepare a raised bed by cultivating or pulverized soil into the fine tilth and raising it to 15 cm high from the ground level and 10 cm thick. So the bed size is 15 cm height and thick fine river sand and edge sawdust is added into the bed preparation. Then seeds are spread in the seed bed. The seeds are covered by putting a level of fine river sand or edge sawdust to a thickness of about 1.5 cm. In rubber, the seed propagation and also vegetative propagation like budding is also done. The stages of seed germination: first, emergence of radical, then seed start to the develop spiral roots, emergence of stem without leaves, fully developed root system and emergence of leaves, and last picture is fully developed seedlings. Then vegetative propagation is budding, green budding. In green budding, first step is whip the base of the stalk with a piece of cloth. Then make two parallel vertical cut at the base of the rootstock stem, 7.5 cm long and 1 cm apart and about 3 cm from the ground. Then third number step is join the two parallel vertical cuts by horizontal QT cut either at the upper or lower ends. Then strip off bark either upward or downward depending on where the horizontal cut was made. Cut away the bark, leaving 1 cm as tongue or hold the bud patch in this position. Then extract bud patch from the bud stick by making similar incision made on the rootstock but a little bit smaller to fit in. The inner side of the bud patch must not be touched, dirt, bent, bruise are exposed to long. Insert immediately the bud patch in the budding panel made on the rootstock, ensuring at the same time that the bud patch is not placed upside and down. Secure the bud patch firmly by tying a piece of transparent budding tape or of about 2 cm wide and 30 cm in length. Open the building tape 21 days after budding. Green bud patch indicates success holding success budding operation, whereas brown or black bud patch indicates budding failure. Cut the rootstock stem 10 cm above the end of the budding panel even days after opening of the budding tape. The scion is expected to sprout in 2 or 3 weeks. this is the procedure of green budding. After the nursery stage, the young budding. In young budding techniques, the seedling stock is raised in polybags of 18 to 38 centimeter lay flat dimension. When the seedlings are about 10 weeks old, having basal stem diameter of 6 mm, they are ready for a young budding operation. The buds used are also green but much younger in age and smaller in size than is normally used in green budding. Nursery. The nurseries are maintained for raising seedlings, budded plants and bud wood. Beds are prepared 60 to 120 cm wide and convenient length with path ways laid in between to facilitate manuring, watering and weeding. The spacing in the nursery according to the type of planting material is as follows. For the raising seedling stump, plant spacing is 23 by 23 cm, 30 by 30 cm and 34 by 20 cm. For the budded stump, 30 cm by 30 cm and for stump buddings, 60 by 60 cm. For budwood nurseries, 90 by 90 or 60 by 120 cm. Then land preparation and layout. The area selected should be cleared of wild growth or weed growth. Silt pits of dimension is 120 by 45 by 60 cm may be taken along the contour at suitable intervals to check erosion and to conserve water. Square planting is suitable for level and near the level lands. Rectangular system with planting lines oriented in east-west direction can be adopted in flat lands and slopes. In undulating or hilly areas, planting should be done in rows across the slope along the contour lines. The planting density is recommended is 420 to 500 plants per hectare. The standard peat of 75 cm cube are dug in advance and filled with topsoil, 12 kg organic matter, 175 gram of rock phosphate, and the planting is done in the center of the peat with shade and much mulch is provided. Types of planting. Seed at stake planting. The planting seed in situ is not found is very successful in the country. Then second is stump planting. Seedling raised in nurseries are transplanted after pruning the same at height of 45 to 60 cm from the collar. Then polybags. Raise stock seedlings in polybags and afterwards the green buds them at the appropriate stage and transplant. Second one is green budded stump are planted in polybags of appropriate size and transplanted. In both the cases, transplanting can be done when the plants attain either 2 to 3 whorls or 6 to 7 whorls of leaves. Fourth number, budded stump planting. Seedling raised in the nurseries are budded and transplanted after pruning the stem at about 8 cm from the budded patch. Bud patch. Then the planting distance. For the budded plants, the spacing in hilly areas is 6.7 by 3.4 meter. Plant population is 445 hectares, number of plants per hectare. Then in plain, 4.9 by 4.9 meter, it's accommodate about 420 plants per hectare. For the seedling trees, the recommended spaces for hilly area is 6.1 by 3.0 meter. It's accommodate about 539 plants per hectare. For the plains, the plant spacing is 4.6 by 4.6 and it's accommodate 479 plants per hectare. Manuring for the immature rubber trees at pre-plant pre-tapping stage. Tapping, that means the extraction of latex. This is the processing product of rubber. Apply 12 kg of compost or FYM and 120 gram of rock phosphate in each pit before planting. Apply 10:2, 10:2, 4:2, 1.5 gram of NPK and magnesium as per schedule given below. For the 3 years of planting, 3 years after planting, the fertilizers are applied in September and October. Recommended fertilizer dose is 225 gram, 190 kg of NPK per plant. So the fertilizer dose is increases up to as the age of the plant is increases. Apply 400 kg of mixture of NPK per hectare in two doses, once in April May and another one in September October, from the fifth year till the tree is ready for tapping. Mature rubber trees under tapping. For mature rubber trees under tapping, apply NPK 10:2, 10:2, 10 grade mixture at the rate of 900 gram per tree, 300 kg per hectare every year in two split doses. Add 10 kg of commercial magnesium sulfate for every 100 kg of the above mixture if there is a magnesium deficiency. Pruning to a height of 2 to 2.5 meter allows the development of smooth trunk without branches or large scars. In polybag budding, allow the plant to grow without punches until 2 to 2.5 meter from union and then prune. Pruning also allows to the development of balanced canopy, maintain 4 to 5 well-spaced branches to avoid wind damage. In rubber trees, the intercrop is also grown, cultivated in the first 2 years. The land area is not fully occupied by the rubber plants and the interspaces can be utilized for growing intercrops which do not interfere with the growth of rubber plants. The common intercrops cultivated in rubber plantation are banana, pineapple, rubber, tuber crops, ginger, turmeric, vegetable crops and medicinal crops. In this picture, we can see the rubber intercrop with cassava. Then cover cropping is also done in rubber cultivation. Cover cropping is desirable in slopy areas as it helps to prevent the soil erosion, and this practice is also assist in enhancing the soil fertility, suppress the weed growth and controls the soil temperature. Although any leguminous crop with spreading habit can be grown, it is preferable to use puria which establish a thick ground cover. Then mulching and weed control. In young rubber trees, the plant need to be mulched by spreading dry leaves, grass, cuttings and cover crops loping around the plants. This is usually done in the month of November to protect the plants from the adverse effect of any possible drought. Weed control. The weeds commonly found in a rubber plantation are Eupatorium, then Chromolaena, Borea, Lantana, Mimosa, etc. So the control measure is application of Diron, Cimazine, Alacor, Paraquat and Glyphosate. Recommended dose. The harvesting of rubber is Hevea latex found in the latex vessels contain 30 to 40% rubber in the form of particles. Latex is obtained from the bark of the rubber trees by tapping. The tapping technique is also called as rilling. During the sixth year, the requisite trunk girth is about 50 centimeters will be reached. At this age, the tree will be ready for tapping, the yield increasing gradually up to 10th year when they will be stabilized. The yield is rubber tree, the yield wise, year wise yield parameter considered from 6th year to 11th year. For the 6th year, 900 kg per hectare, then 1300, 1500, 1800, and the 11th year, 2000 kg of yield per plant per year. For working out the economics and the economic life of rubber tree is considered as 25 years. This is the cultivation of rubber. Thank you.